So let's think of the following riddle. I have a target, I have a drone, I want the drone to be able to land on the target. But in this case, I want the drone to be able to land as if it was an airplane. So not approaching it from vertically, but from diagonal, say with a 30 degrees approaching angle. So I will have my target aimed, say, in a 45 degrees angle like that, and I want the drone to land, but not necessarily on the target, but looking at the target. For that, I might required to have the angle of the camera to change while landing. So at the first part of approaching, it will be fixed to, say, 30 degrees. Let's say it's at 30 degrees. But at the very last part of the final, we might want to have this camera upwards. And then being able to land with respect to this target, not touching it, but say within 1 meter for that. So here are a few hints how to approach this problem. First of all, we might want to add up an extra value, which is not just the Y or the pitch and the roll controller. We want to and the altitude. We want to end up the distance from the target. The distance from the target could be computed, approximated, by knowing the actual distance, say the diagonal of the target, in this example, say 25 centimeters, knowing my field of view, my resolution. Maybe it will require some sort of calibration of the camera, but knowing the number of pixels this target is actually being captured in the video, I can approximate the distance. Say I'm 2 meters away from the target, so the target will take 50 pixels. Now I'm 100, I'm 1 meter, 100 centimeter from the target, then the target will take 100 pixels, twice as much. So I have some sort of measuring of the distance with respect to my target, and this also could be controlled. So I have a control for the height, for the pitch and roll. I have a control for the attitude. I have a control for the relative speed, because it might want to land on a moving target. And to summarize and to add up an extra complexity, I might want to be able to move or to take in consideration the angle of the actual camera. As mentioned before, at the beginning of the land, I want to approach it from a certain angle, but in the very last part, in the final, I want to move the camera upwards so it can land in this manner. Combining those together are quite complicated, but still, the notion, in order to have this nicely engineered, is quite simple. And here is the recipe. First of all, each controller works independently. You want to have your pitch with respect to the actual angle required. You want to know the angle of the camera and put it in consideration. Have your sinus and cosinus computed rightly where I should go. But in simple terms, as before, I want the target to be focused in the middle of the video. I want to adapt a certain rate of approximating or velocity with respect to the target, a certain descent rate, and a certain parameters for PID for each of the controllers, the roll and the pitch, so it will do the following. I might put some stages or states in the big autonomous landing state. So maybe hovering and then approaching and then maybe dividing the last part of the landing to two parts where my PID values could be different, or my behavioral, meaning changing the angle of the camera. Those types of riddles are complicated. Obviously, there are big drone companies or autonomous vehicles or drones companies that works on them. But the ability of implementing them or just designing them and playing with them are you to play. You don't have a drone, you have a simulator. You can put a target in your simulator and try to land in an angular manner.